we're comparing singers' most popular songs to their most critically acclaimed songs. Let's go. Ariana Grande's Seven Rings is her most popular. She should be a savage, guys. This song is growing on me. I didn't like it initially. It's got something. The production's always stellar on Ariana Grande's songs. She wants it. She's got it. You always wonder, like, to what extent are those her real friends, or are they just like a bunch of models? Would you hire your real friends to hang out with you on a set all day and just work hard and be sweaty and gross? It's probably a bunch of models. And here's her most critically acclaimed song, Thank You, Next. I could say thank you to Malcolm, 'cause he was an angel. One taught me love, one taught me patience. It's like Legally Blonde music video. I do like this song more. It's more melodic, I think. Less cool for sure, but... Something I always wonder about that song is whether it's actually sincere, like, oh, thank you, all my exes, for teaching me blah, 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 or if it's just like, thank you, next. Like, there's more emphasis on the next, like, oh, no more of that. Anyway, here's a critic quote for this song. Every time Ariana Grande releases a new song, you think it can't be any better than the last, and it always is. We had it with No Tears Left to Cry, that's a sick song. And then we got God is a Woman. Well, now we got Thank You, Next, and I'm pretty sure everyone's jaws dropped to the floor. I'm gonna go ahead and give this one to the critic. Thank You, Next is super catchy, and it's one of those songs that could work in any scenario with any instrumentation. Here we have Coldplay's most popular song, Something Just Like This, with the Chainsmokers. But this is such a Chainsmokers song. She said, where'd you wanna go? It's even the Chainsmokers chords. I'm not looking for somebody. I can see why it's the most popular, though, because it's hypier. He sings great here, too. I think Chainsmokers auto-tuned his vocals a little bit more, and I like the sound of that. They're always really loose with Chris Martin when they auto-tune his voice, and he's a little bit of a pitchy guy, so the Chainsmokers kind of went in and really it made his voice and tone, which is really nice, just stand out a little bit more to me. And here we have Coldplay's most critically acclaimed song, Viva La Vida, which is just, oh, that's a great song. Actually, this one's also pretty tuned, I think. Or it's just like he was more in tune when we're singing. I don't really like the BTS collab they did recently because his vocals just don't sound right to me. I think part of his pitch, some of it is just tone and stuff, but he is an incredible singer, as evident in both of these songs. A little bit flat there. This is a weird music video. This looks like some iMovie filter. Critic quote time. Coldplay is wonderful and I love many of their songs, but for me, Viva La Vida is the best. You can really connect with it. Like others said, you feel like you are the king. It has some of the best lyrics to a Coldplay song, and Coldplay is lyrically brilliant. I love the strings in a rock song, and Martin's voice is amazing in this song. I'm gonna go ahead and once again give it to the critics. I think that's popular because it's easier to fit into playlists. You can play it at parties, stuff like that. You don't really play Viva La Vida and you're like, ugh! But it's a better song if you just kind of like listen to music. Depends how you quantify what a good song is. Maybe a good song to you is like you can work out to it, you can party to it. Then you probably want to choose something just like this. By the way, welcome back to another video. My name's Joel from Room Official. And the most popular songs in this video are the ones that have the most plays on Spotify. And the critically acclaimed ones are the ones with the highest average score from critics. Makes sense, right? Here we have Justin Bieber. His most popular song, Love Yourself. Ed Sheeran wrote that. You think I'm crying on my own? Well, I ain't. And I didn't want to. The guitar is kind of out of tune. 'Cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care or don't. But you still hit my phone up. And baby, I'll be moving on. And I think with a super tuned vocals, it's like you can really hear that the guitar is like. Maybe you should know that. I never thought about that before. Don't like you, and she likes everyone. And very good lyrics, I think. To admit that I was wrong. And here we have his most critically acclaimed song, Where Are You Now, with Jack Yu. Jack Yu is Diplo and Skrillex. Just admit it. Oh, this is a great song. See, I gave you faith, turned your doubt into hope. Can't deny those melodies. Now I'm all alone and my joys turn them open. Tell me here. One of his best vocal performances too, I think. Where are you now that I need you? Yeah! That drop is sick. The pitch up vocal line in the hook is instantly recognizable and was certainly a game changer in the pop and dance production world at the time. Oh yeah, though.
thing.
Where Are You Now is truly a milestone in the pop dance crossover canon, and it will remain one of Bieber's, Skrillex, and Diplo's best songs for perceivably the rest of the trio's career. Yeah, I have to say, when Skrillex started getting into pop and working with Bieber and stuff, unbelievable. He's such a genius. I don't know how much Diplo was involved as well, but just this trio together made some awesome, interesting music. Once again, I gotta give it to Critic. And here we have Lil Pitchy with his most popular song, Living For That. Wishing we could just escape. Wishing we could just escape. Very cool. Yeah, but when we out all night, do the shit we like, we living for that. Yeah, I love that. The soundscape, beautiful, the production. And here we have Lil Pitchy's most critically acclaimed song, It Kills Me. Oh yeah. That's a little feature by Jax. What a banger. And here we have the critic's quote. This is probably the best song of our generation. Jiva, my editor. I'm actually gonna give that one to Popular. I do think Living For That might be the stronger song. It kills me to choose one of these guys. I like them both so much. I might have been involved in these songs, whatever. Let's move on. And here we have Elvis Presley with his most popular song, Can't Help Falling In Love. If I falling in love with you. So low. His vocals are... Okay, and here's Elvis's most critically acclaimed song, Hound Dog. You ain't not gonna... Yeah, let's go. You ain't not gonna... A lot of these old rock songs are so similar. The girls are going crazy. They had never seen anyone shake their hips before. Controversial in its day, Hound Dog is now considered one of the biggest influences on the rock and roll genre. Huh. And was Presley's biggest selling single, spending a record-setting 11 weeks at number one in 1956, a record which stood for 36 years. Hound Dog was eventually inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame in 1988. Wow, that's very late. And got listed as one of 500 songs that shaped rock and roll by the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I think I Can't Help Falling In Love With You is the better song, actually, as far as melodies and stuff go. As far as live performances go, Hound Dog was way stronger, but I'm gonna have to give this one to Popular.
Cause I can't help.
Beautiful. Here I have Lady Gaga's most popular song, Shallow, from that one movie, A Star Is Born. Ain't it hard keeping it so hardcore? I'm falling. She's become an actress now. Like, she's in that Hasaguchi movie as well. And in the bad times, I fear myself. Sings great here. Yeah, that's a high C. That's such a sweet spot for her voice. Like, the collab she had with Ariana Grande, for that whole song, it felt like, oh, Ariana's obviously the stronger singer of the two. But just that Lady Gaga has a way more powerful voice, like it's got more muscle to it, I guess. So Ariana just kind of sang circles around her on that song because that worked on that song. But on a song like this, I think Ariana would not have the same belting power. I'm off the deep end. Watches I dive in, I never meet the ground. And here we have Lady Gaga's most critically acclaimed song, Bad Romance. This is the Red One era, where she worked with the producer Red One. Super poppy. Very cool. Ah, that freaking ice. It looks like a cheap Snapchat filter now. I do like those chord progressions, actually. This is hard. I like both these songs. Not only is this one of the most memorable pop singles of the late noughties, I always hate when they call it the noughties, like the 2000s. Bad Romance well and truly established Lady Gaga as an icon to be reckoned with. I'm gonna give it to critics one more time. Bad Romance is a banger. You could probably arrange that song in a similar way to Shallow, and it would sound just as good. It's just different kind of arrangements. I want your loving, I want your revenge. You and me could have a bad romance. Here we have Kelly Clarkson's most popular song, Because of You. Felt so hard. I've learned the hard way to never. So vulnerable and nice, like the lyrics and everything. Because of you, I chills. Too far from the because of you, she's got such a voice. Me when I'm on the phone, Jiva comes over, show his drawings or his edits. And here we have Kelly Clarkson's most critically acclaimed song, Since You've Been Gone. As far as pop songs go, this one might be better. This is some Max Martin thing. Apparently this was way more electronic when Max Martin wrote it, and then she was like, I want it to be bandier. And we got this, which is sick. That's such like a rock girl cliche to do this thing. When you look back on your click wheel iPod, does anything else capture the turning point between the golden era of pop princesses and the impeding rise of indie quite like Since You've Been Gone? No. And that's why it was so successful, so memorable, and so fudging good. Since You've Been Gone was the best pop song of 2005 and also of all time, probably. I love Max Martin, but honestly, I don't get an emotional impact in the same way that I do from the most popular songs. I'm gonna give it to most popular here. Again, as a pop song, Since You've Been Gone freaking slays. But because of you gives me trauma. Trauma of a dad that worked out that I've never had, but I feel like he did listening to the song. Here we have Adele's most popular song, Hello. You ever heard this one? That you will. Cool tattoos. Did you ever make it out? I always wonder about poses like this, like... Like, it's kind of the normal pose equivalent of kind of, you could just as well do this. Hello. Like, that's just as natural as this. So hello from the other side. I get that there's some symbolism of like looking back on something, kind of like, oh yeah, the thing we had. Freaking voice, man. And here we have her most critically acclaimed song, Rolling in the Deep. I was always fascinated by this music video, like what dimension does this play out in? What is this house? So much flower on the ground here. sick voice. Sick. Adele was hardly a rookie when she dropped Rolling in the Deep, but this is the hit that made her a legend as far as the whole world was concerned. Reeling from the rubbish relationship, that's so British, that inspired her breakthrough 21, Adele poured her pain into this smash. Rolling in the Deep sounded like nothing else on the radio in 2011, but right from the dramatic opening moments, you could tell this was a song and an artist's here to stay. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and give it to Critic here as well. There's definitely other Adele songs I like a lot more, but since we are choosing between critically acclaimed and most popular, Rolling in the Deep is better than Hello. Here we have the Rolling Stones' most popular song, Paint It Black. I see a red door. I've like barely heard this song. Such a cool sound. Feels so familiar. And here we have the Rolling Stones' most critically acclaimed song, I Can't Get No Satisfaction. Now this one I've heard. So iconic. Terrible sound mixing. Sounds like a B. I mean, nothing else sounds like that, but it just sounds bad. That's common with so much distinctive music, that like the way you make it distinctive is to just find a sound that sounds terrible. Released as a single on August 20, 1965, I Can't Get No Satisfaction features the Rolling Stones in their prime, defying exactly what rock and roll is about. The single was a great success and has earned the band the number 2 position on the Rolling Stone magazine's list of greatest songs of all time. What? Yeah, I'm gonna give that one to critics once more. It's almost like I am a critic myself. Here we have Kanye West with his most popular song, Stronger. I love this song so much. I know it's a sample, but his rapping just adds so much. I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night, man. That's how long I've been on ya. I need you right now. You could be my black Kate Moss tonight. Play secretary on the ball tonight. How cool is that? The beat is cool too. Kristen and Kristen Dior. Poppy Kanye West peak. There were a few really good songs on Donda, but that is... And here we have Runaway, his most critically acclaimed song with Pusha T. And I always find, always find something wrong. You've been putting up with my just way too long. Kanye has so many great songs. I'm so gifted at finding what I don't like the most. So I think it's time for us to have a toast. Something a little bit annoying to me with the notes they chose for the piano. This is what you would call a doubled third, which is one of those things that you usually avoid in music. When the bass goes down to the dominant with a third in the bass. So the whole thing is an E major, and then it go down to B with E flat in the bass. They do this. It's just something about it, I don't know. It feels dissonant almost. It's a cool song though. It's definitely on purpose. Anyway, in many ways, Runaway marks the transition between the old Kanye and the current one. More importantly, however, it's a lamb. Fine piece of music. What? Is this my researchers who have been doing this, like to change the swear words? Or anyway, I'm gonna have to give this one to Popular. Come on, come on, Stronger. Party to that any day of the week. Here we have MGMT's most popular song called Kids. But your voice is too loud. Ah, you can just imagine what that sounds like. These masks, man, I'm gonna have nightmares. Is that what it's like to be a kid? I remember my childhood better than this. And here we have their most critically acclaimed song, Time to Pretend. Oh yeah, I remember this. I hate that lead sound. So annoying. It's like a freaking mosquito. I'm feeling rough, I'm feeling wrong. But at least we get shirtless men. That's you, man. I do like the sound of this. It's like super indie. This is our decision. Oh, that's nice. Love this soundscape. We got the vision. Now let's have some fun. That's cool. Okay, MGMT was never supposed to make it big. Look at what they're making these days. Psychedelic music indebted largely to the 1970s and unconcerned with fans that wanted them to just make synth-laced hits. Yet with Time to Pretend, a song that was inspired by a praying mantis they had in their house in college, they imagined the rock star lifestyle. The lyrics seemed tongue-in-cheek in a careless, sort of half-joking way, but in that fantasy, MGMT stumbled on the hit that would end up making them stars for real. I really, really like this last song, the Critic song. Let's go with that one. Beautiful melodies. Soundscapes. The other one scarred me for life. Maybe that's why I don't like this song as much. Here we have Elton John's most popular song, Rocket Man. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. Such a great era for music. Such a great songwriter. I am a bigger fan of Elton John's later stuff when his voice was lower. Freaking Lion King era, Elton John. And here's Elton John's most critically acclaimed song, Your Song, which is also featured in Moulin Rouge, one of my favorite movies when I was a kid. My gift is my song, yeah, and this one's for you. And you can tell everybody. The melody, it's just so romantic, the lyrics. So cute. Maybe quite simple, but now that it's done. How nice is that? It's just the cutest little poetry set to music. This one of Elton John's most loved songs ever began as a humble B-side to Take Me to the Pilot before radio stations flipped it, triggering the golden run of hits, which turned Elton John into the world's biggest pop star. In subsequent decades, countless couples have taken his advice to tell everybody, this is your song. So freaking nice. I'm gonna give that one to Critics as well. Your Song. What a tune. Okay, guys, get here for more similar music VS videos, get here for music commentary videos, and we have Critics 9, Popular 4. So critics are the best. The population sucks. Music listeners, I'm kidding. I don't know. I guess I'm a critic. I'll see you in the next one. Take care. I love you. You know what I'm talking about.